Hello children, welcome to AIIMS India's online classes. This is biology session. You are watching Diversity in Living Organisms part 7. So far we have been discussing about the living organisms and their diversity in plants completed, diversity in animal kingdom we are discussing. In that, in the last class, classification of animal kingdom into phyla. The first, porifera. What are poriferans? The poriferans are commonly known as sponges. They are generally marine and asymmetrical. They are not symmetrical. Okay? And they are their body is porous. Okay, and some examples we have studied. What are they? That is cycan, Eusporangia, Spongilla. These are the common examples of porifera. Okay, they possess a canal system, isn't it? And cycan is the common sponge. Its scientific name is Scypha. And Spongilla is the freshwater sponge. And Eusporangia is also called as a bath sponge. Okay. What is the second phyla? Coelenterata. Coelenterata is also called Cnidaria. They are aquatic. They are mostly marine. And they are sessile. Okay, they may be sessile or free swimming, but here they are radially symmetrical. Okay, the cnidarians, they are so called because of presence of cnidoblasts, special cells, or they are also called cnidocytes. Okay, which contain stinging capsules or nematocysts. Okay, and they show two forms, polyp and medusa. Okay, so cnidarians exist both in both forms. The alternation of generation is observed in this. That is called metagenesis. You will study in higher classes. Okay, so polyps produce medusae asexually, and medusae form the polyps sexually. Okay, example Obelia, and one example Hydra is the most common example for the coelenterates. Okay, Aurelia, Adamsia, like that polyp and medusa forms you can see. Physalia, one example in the phylum Coelenterata, it is called Portuguese man of war. Adamsia, it is also called sea anemone. Pennatula, it is also called sea pen. Gorgonia, it is also called sea fan. And Meandrina, it is a coral, by name brain coral. Okay, corals and coral reefs also come under this phylum Coelenterata. They occupy several kilometers under the seabed. Okay, next. Helminths, we have discussed about the helminths. They are dorsiventrally flattened. Example, platyhelminths are dorsiventrally flattened, hence they are called flatworms. Okay, and they are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic. What is the meaning of triploblastic? The triploblastic means they possess three layers. What are they? Ectoderm, outer ectoderm, inner endoderm, and middle mesoderm. Okay, so these are dorsiventrally flattened. They are called flatworms. Example, tapeworm and liver fluke, the common examples. Okay, and tapeworm is also called Tinea solium, the scientific name, And the liver fluke is also called, the scientific name of liver fluke is Fasciola hepatica. So next, Ascihelminths or Nematihelminths. The body of these animals is circular. Okay, it is not flat, it is circular. And they are also triploblastic. And most of them are parasitic. So as they are circular, they are also called roundworms. Okay, example, Ascaris lumbricoides. It is the common roundworm. Okay. And Eukarya brancofti, it is a filarial worm. And Enchirostoma duodenale, it is also called hookworm. Okay. And we ended with another discussion, that is Annelida. The phylum Annelida, they may be aquatic, marine and freshwater, and even terrestrial also. Means, as we move from the porifera to Annelida, some changes, the evolutionary changes, some advanced characters, okay, compared to the poriferans, Annelids are more advanced. Their tissue level organization to organ level organization, organ system level organization is exhibited by Annelids, okay. And most of them are free living and some are parasitic in nature. The body is segmented. And examples of these animals, Ferritima is an earthworm, common earthworm. And Hirudinaria, it is a blood sucking leech. Neris, okay, Scolopendra. The Neris is another example of this Hirudinaria, another example of this Annelida. Okay, leech, Hirudinaria, and earthworm, the scientific name is Ferritima postuma or Megascolex. There are two main varieties are there. Okay, so let us proceed, children. Today some more phyla, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata. Okay, so there is a great diversity in animal kingdom. Let us proceed. Phylum Arthropoda. This phylum Arthropoda. The phylum Arthropoda is another important characteristic feature. These are the largest phylum of Animalia, which includes insects, and this is probably the largest group of animals, we can say. And it includes the insects. These animals are bilaterally symmetrical and segmented. There is an open circulatory system, open type of circulatory system. Okay, they have organ system level of organization only, these animals also. And if you take the circulatory system, it is open type. There are no special blood vessels. Okay, does not, the blood does not flow in the well-defined blood vessels. The coelomic cavity is blood-filled. That's why it is called hemocoel. Hemocoel. The most characteristic feature of these animals, arthropods, is jointed legs. Some familiar examples of these arthropoda: prawns, okay, butterfly, spiders, scorpion, okay, and crabs, cockroaches. So many, it is the biggest, largest phylum. Okay, this is the largest phylum of Animalia or animal kingdom, which includes insects. So over 2/3 of all named species on the earth are arthropods. Okay, they have organ system level organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, they also possess a three layers. Okay, body is segmented, and coelomate animals, coelom is present. The body of arthropods is covered by the chitinous exoskeleton. Okay, and the body consists of three main parts: head, thorax, and abdomen. Head, thorax, and abdomen. Okay, they have jointed appendages. Arthros means joint, poda means appendages. The respiratory organs are gills, book lungs, book gills, okay, or tracheal system. The circulatory system is of a open type. Sensory organs like antennae, you can see this antennae here, here, okay, antennae, they possess and eyes. The eyes are compound and simple eyes. Steatocysts or balancing organs are present. Excretion takes place through Malpighian tubules. They are mostly dioecious. Okay, fertilization is usually internal. Dioecious means unisexual. Okay, fertilization is usually internal, and they are mostly oviparous, egg laying. Okay, development may be direct or indirect. Direct means without larvae. Indirect means with larval stage. Okay, you know very well some economically important insects are also there, like Apis, honeybee, Bombyx, that is silkworm, Lassifer, lac insect. Okay, and there are some disease transmitting agents, vectors. Example: Anopheles mosquito, Culex mosquito, Aedes mosquito. Okay, gregarious pests are also there, like Locusta, locust insect. Okay, grasshoppers, large grasshoppers. Okay, and living fossils are also present in this. King crab, that is Limulus. Okay, so mostly finally these arthropods are the largest group of animals. Next, mollusks. It is the second largest group. It is the second largest animal phylum. Molluscans, most of them are terrestrial or aquatic. In aquatic, if you take marine or freshwater, having an organ system level organization. They are also bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and coelomate animals. The most distinct feature of these animals is the body is covered by a calcareous shell and is unsegmented with a distinct head. This is the head, distinct head. Muscular foot and visceral hump. Okay, so this is the characteristic feature of these molluscans. In the animals of this group, there is a bilateral asymmetry. The coelomic cavity is reduced. There is a little segmentation. They have an open type of circulatory system, just like arthropods. Kidney-like organs for excretion. In arthropods, Malpighian tubules. Okay, there is a foot that is used for moving around. The examples of this: snails and mussels. Okay, a soft and spongy layer of skin forms a mantle over the visceral hump. This is the mantle over the visceral hump. Okay, the space between the hump and the mantle is called a mantle cavity, in which feather like gills are present. They have respiratory and excretory functions. The anterior head region has sensory tentacles. These two, they are sensory tentacles. The mouth contains a file like rasping organ, so that is called as a radula. It is saw like okay, just like the edges of saw, the tongue okay, that is a radula, and they are usually dioecious, means unisexual, male and female are separate, and oviparous, they also lay the eggs with indirect development. Indirect development means in their development they show larval forms. Okay, example, Pila snail, apple snail, it is also called Pila globosa, common examples. Or even oysters, pearl oyster, Pinctada vulgaris, Pinctada vulgaris. The next, sepia, cuttlefish, it is also called loligo, squid. Okay, it is also called a squid. Octopus, it is also called devil fish, octopus. Okay, and aplysia means it is also called sea hare, and dentalium, tusk shell, it is also called, and Chitoplura, Chitoplura is also called chitin, it is also an example of these molluscans. Okay, next, Echinodermata. These are the animals have an endoskeleton of calcareous ossicles, and hence the name Echinodermata. Echinodermata means spiny bodied, okay, spiny bodied animals or spiny skilled animals. Okay, all are marine, they are exclusively marine. Echinoderms are exclusively marine. So in Greek, echinus means hedgehog, and derma means skin. Thus, these are spiny skinned animals, organisms. These are exclusively free living marine animals, and they are triploblastic in nature and have a coelomic cavity. Okay, all are marine with organ system level organization. The adult echinoderms are radially symmetrical, but the larvae are bilaterally symmetrical. They are triploblastic and coelomate animals. The digestive system is completely developed with mouth on the lower or ventral side and the anus on the upper side. Okay, that is dorsal side. The most distinctive feature of echinoderms is the presence of water vascular system. Okay, in sponges canal system we have observed, and in these echinoderms the presence of water vascular system is the most distinctive feature, which helps the organism in locomotion, capture and transport of food, and respiration, okay, etc. An excretory system is absent in these echinoderms. Excretory system is absent. And they also have a peculiar water-driven tube system that they use for the moving around. So that is called water vascular system. So they have hard calcium carbonate structures that they use as a skeleton. Okay, and example, starfish, sea urchins. Okay, here also these animals are dioecious, sexes are separate, reproduction is sexual, fertilization is usually external, and the development is indirect, and they show several larval forms, that's why the development is indirect. Okay, free living swimming larvae are present. So example, Asterias, the common example, starfish, Asterias, and Echinus. Echinus means it is also called sea urchin. And Antedon, it is also called sea lily. And Cucumeria, it is also called, the common name is sea cucumber. And Ophura, it is also called brittle star. Okay? So this is about the echinoderms. Next, come to the chordates. Okay? The phylum, Protochordata. So this phylum Chordata is divided into, so before that actually Hemichordata is present. Hemichordata was earlier considered as the subphylum under the phylum Chordata, but now it is placed as a separate phylum under non-chordata, okay, Hemichordata. So this phylum consists of a small group of worm-like marine animals with organ system level organization. They are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and coelomate animals. The body is cylindrical and is composed of an anterior proboscis, a collar, and a long trunk. Okay, the best example is balanoglossus and sacoglossus. Okay, the circulatory system is of open type, and respiration takes place through gills. Excretory organs is proboscis gland. Okay, the sexes are separate, that is dioecious. The fertilization is external and the development is indirect. Hemichordata. Hemichordata example, balanoglossus and sacoglossus. And now come to the phylum Chordata. The animals belonging to the phylum Chordata are fundamentally characterized by the presence of a notochord, a dorsal hollow nerve cord, and paired pharyngeal gill slits. Paired pharyngeal gill slits. So these chordates are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomate, with organ system level of organization. They possess a post-anal tane and a closed type of circulatory system. Okay? And the phylum Chordata is divided into three subphyla, that is Urochordata or Tunicata, Cephalochordata, and Vertebrata. Okay, the subphylum Urochordata and Cephalochordata are often referred to as Protochordata. Okay, here directly given in your higher classes you will study this. So actually the subphylum Urochordata and Cephalochordata are often referred to as Protochordata. Okay, now come to Protochordata. So these animals are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, and have a coelome. Coelome means body cavity. Okay. In addition, they show a new feature of the body design, namely a notochord. At least at some stages during their lives, the notochord is a long rod-like support structure. Cord means string, so that runs along the back of the animal, separating the nervous tissue from the gut. Okay, notochord is the most distinct feature of these protochordates. Okay, so these chordates are exclusively marine. In Urochordata, notochord is present only in larval tail. While in Cephalochordata, it extends from head to tail region and is persistent throughout their life. Okay, Urochordata example, Acedia salpa. And another example of Urochordata, Doliolum. Cephalochordata example, Branchiostoma, that is also called Amphiaxis. Okay, Cephalochordata. Urochordata, Hadmania. Okay, Acedia, Salpa, Doliolum. Okay, this Hadmania, these are examples of Urochordata. The members of the phylum, next, so it provides a place for, this notochord provides a place for the muscles to attach for ease of movement. Okay, the protochordates may not have a proper notochord present at all stages in their lives or for the entire length of the animal. The protochordates are marine animals. Example, balanoglossus, actually it is a hemichordata, okay, and Hadmania and Amphiaxis. These are the examples of the Urochordata and Cephalochordata. Okay. So the members of the subphylum Vertebrata possess notochord during the embryonic period. The notochord is replaced by a cartilaginous or bony vertebral column in the adult. Okay, thus all the vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. Interesting. Okay. All vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. Okay. Besides the basic chordate characters, vertebrates have a ventral muscular heart with 2, 3, or 4 chambers, and kidney for excretion and osmoregulation, and the paired appendages which may be fins or limbs. Okay, vertebrates characteristic feature. Okay, that's why this vertebrata is having the divisions, anatta and natostomata. Okay, so again anatta, it has a cyclostomata. Natostomata is again divided into super classes, pisces and tetrapoda. Pisces means again divided into two: chondrichthys, that is cartilaginous fishes; osteichthys, that is a bony fishes. The tetrapoda is the super class of natostomata. Okay, vertebrata is divided into two divisions: anatta, lack of jaws. Okay, and natostomata, they bear jaws. Natostomata is divided into two super classes, that is pisces, they bear fins, and tetrapoda, they bear limbs. The tetrapoda is again divided into four classes: amphibia, reptilia, aves, and mammalia. Okay, so chordate or vertebrata, once again, these are the animals having a true vertebral column and internal skeleton, allowing a completely different distribution of muscle attachment points to be used for the movement. Vertebrates are bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, coelomic, and segmented, with complex differentiation of body tissues and organs. All chordates possess the following features. What are they? Have a notochord, have a dorsal nerve cord, triploblastic, have paired gill pouches, okay, coelomates. Vertebrates are grouped into five classes: pisces, amphibians, reptiles, birds or aves, and mammals. Okay, so more about these animals we need to discuss. Okay, if you take these pisces are divided into two: cyclostomes and the chondrichthys, osteichthys. Okay, class cyclostomata, it includes ectoparasites or jawless vertebrates. Example, petromyzon. Example, petromyzon. And they have an elongated body bearing gill slits. Whereas the chondrichthys are the marine fishes with a streamlined body and have cartilaginous endoskeleton. The mouth is located ventrally, notochord is persistent, and they possess an operculum. Okay, the gills cover. Actually, operculum is absent in the chondrichthys. They are present, operculum is present in the osteichthys, means bony fishes. Example of these chondrichthys: scoliodon, dogfish; pristis, it is also called sawfish; and Carcharodon, a great white shark, okay, and Trigon. Trigon is a stinging ray fish. Next, osteichthyes. Osteichthyes include the both marine and freshwater fishes with bony endoskeleton. Their body is streamlined and the body is mostly terminal. And they have four pairs of gills which are covered by an operculum. Okay. And example, marine fishes, Exocetus, flying fish, hippocampus, seahorse it is called. Freshwater fishes, example, Labiorohita, it is also called Rohu, Katla, okay, these are freshwater fishes. Clarias, it is also called Magur, and the aquarium fishes is also there, the fighting fish, Betta, and Pterophyllum, angel fish it is also called, okay. Next, amphibia. Amphibia include the name itself, the animals which lead dwell life, okay. The amphibians can live in aquatic as well as the terrestrial habitats. Most of them have two pairs of limbs. The body is divisible into head and trunk, okay. And examples of these amphibia, salamanders, frogs, okay. Example, buffo, it is a toad. Rana tigrina, it is a frog. Hyla, it is a tree frog. Salamander, okay. Ichthyophis, it is a limbless amphibian, okay. Next, come to the reptiles. Reptilia, the class name refers to the creeping or crawling mode of locomotions. In Latin, repier or reptum means to creep or crawl, okay. And they are mostly terrestrial animals and their body is covered by dry and conified skin. Epidermal scales or scutes are present. They do not have external ears, okay. And most of them are oviparous, okay. Examples, Chilon, turtle. Testudo is tortoise. Chameleon, it is a tree lizard. Calotis, garden lizard. Crocodilus, that is the crocodile. Alligator, okay. And Hemidactylus, it is a wall lizard. The poisonous snakes like Naja, Cobra, Bengaris, Crate, okay. And Vipers, these are all the snakes, lizards, turtles. They are the examples of reptiles, okay. And next, Aves. Aves means birds. The characteristic feature of these birds, the presence of feathers. And most of them can fly except the flightless birds, okay, ostrich for example. And they possess beak. The forelimbs are modified into wings. The hind limbs generally have the scales that are modified for walking, swimming or clasping the trees, okay. And these birds, example, Corvus, Crow, Columbia, Pigeon, Sitacula, Parrot, Struthio, Ostrich, Pavo cristatus, that is Peacock, and Tinoditis is a penguin, Neophron, Vulture. Okay, these are all, there are so many examples are there. Okay, next, last one is the mammals. The class Mammalia, they found in a variety of habitats, polar ice caps, deserts, mountains, forests, grasslands and dark caves. Some of them have adapted to fly also or live in water. The most unique mammalian characteristic is the presence of milk producing glands, mammary glands, by which the young ones are nourished. Okay. They have two pairs of limbs adapted for walking, running, climbing, burrowing, swimming or flying, okay. So they are most advanced animals, we can say. And the mammals, another unique feature is presence of hair and presence of external ear, pinna, okay. Examples, they are, okay. even human beings also come under the example. Rats, cats, dogs, elephants, horse, okay, and the flying mammal, that is bat, okay, these are all the examples. Okay, children, so this is the brief discussion of the vertebrates. Okay, the phylum vertebrate is grouped into five classes: fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals. Okay, please read the textbook. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon for receiving latest updates.